So yeah, different, but it will be okay. It will be okay. So,
BFB's third birthday is tomorrow, Christine.
So exciting. Let's see. All right. Okay, if you have a breakout room, then I want you to join your breakout room. If you don't, you're gonna stay with me and we're gonna do our breakout, we're gonna do our morning circle here together. Calvin, can you hit join breakout room? Can you hit join breakout room?
Can I, Christine, can I, Miss Rossetti, can I get into that room too, please?
Yeah, you should be able to, when you hit breakout rooms.
Just join.
And then hit join.
Got it, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. All right, you guys, good morning.
Christine, I'm losing a third tooth.
You are? That's crazy. That's crazy.
I'm gonna lose a third tooth in November 2020.
That's right. So that happens when we're growing up. We lose our teeth and we get our adult teeth in. Yeah. Good morning, Aiden.
Oh, hi.
Hi, thanks, buddy. All right, we're gonna get to our good morning, Genesis. Get to our circle. What, Genesis? I didn't pull up our circle yet. Sorry, guys. Gotta have a little patience this morning. All right. Oh, Vincent, that's too loud, friend.
It's November, everyone!
Vincent, too loud. Hurts our ears.
Hurts our ears.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I will.
All right, Josh.
I'm getting the oldest in
November.
Yeah, just like.
All right. We know, Vincent, that you're excited about November. It is November. Good morning. Today is a brand new month. It's November. Yeah. I know.
Yeah.
It's November. It's November 2nd today, 2020. What number month is November? Does somebody know? October was number 10. November is number
11. And next December is 12.
That's right. We're starting a whole new unit of study. We're going to be talking about Native Americans and the settlers that came over from England. And we're going to be learning some new computer skills in November. Yeah, some new computer skills. What, Hannah?
You gonna school on Sunday?
Yeah, I think you better come to school on Sunday. I think that's a good idea. What do you think? Are you gonna come to school on Sunday? Hannah, are you coming to school on Sunday? Yes or no?
No.
How about Thanksgiving? Should we come to school on Thanksgiving?
No.
No. Yeah.
No.
Those are days
because
off.
Thanksgiving is a holiday.
That's right. That's right.
Yes.
And holidays we don't got school.
That's right. We have a whole new library that we're going to explore. I'll show it to you. It's going to be super cool.
Except for this burp.
Super cool.
Indigenous.
Indigenous. Indigenous.
Library.
Indigenous people.
Indigenous library.
Indigenous.
Halifax. Welcome to the Indigenous Library.
Yeah, this is all stories about Indigenous people, which are the Native Americans. Yeah. We'll be reading some of these stories as we go through the month. This is some of the artwork that they created, or the different...
It's Rossetti! It's November Library!
Created. Yeah.
You're right, it's the November Library.
Here's some
library.
Of the artwork. There's a totem pole.
See, it's also November.
Yeah.
Today's my first day of November in class.
This is my
birthday. Lots of things here. Emily, what do you see that interests you? What do you see that you like?
And I like the
You hold me up.
Yeah, yeah. Cool. Hannah, what do you like? What do you see that you like?
I don't know.
You don't know. Alejandro, what do you see that you like?
Target.
I don't know.
I'm checking this computer. So now I'm in a living room of glass.
Genesis, what do you see that you like?
Miss Rossetti, guess what?
Fried bread.
Miss Rossetti.
Fried bread.
Guess what, Miss Rossetti?
Fried bread.
I'm in the living room, of course.
All right, so we'll be reading a story from there.
Right,
and now, I think we'll sing our good morning song. Oops. We've got some different things on here, don't we? We have pumpkin and a Thanksgiving Day turkey.
Hey, Mommy. A computer in the living room.
You're in the living room.
Ready?
Yes.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Miss Pat.
Are you ready for a brand new day?
Yeah.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
How are you?
It's so nice to have you here with me today. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Just fine. Howdy, howdy, you do, hello, good day.
Now that we're together, learning so much fun, the more of us, the better. So come on, everyone. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Just fine. Howdy, howdy, you do, hello, good day.
No.
Miss Rossetti.
Good morning.
The new McDonald's turn one.
How do you do? Hello, good day. Now that we're together, learning so much fun.
November 2nd, 2020. We have calendar. We have small groups. We have PE with Mr. Miller. And then we have lunch and recess. We have reading. Yeah. And we have a break. We have content and closing circle. You know what I forgot to add? We have yoga before we have reading. That's when we do like bee breath and bear breath and all of that kind of stuff. And I forgot to add that in. We'll fix that in a minute. All right. Good morning.
Fall back.
What does this mean?
It's time for fall. Turkey Day.
Turkey Day? Yeah, but.
Not you. What is there one of these?
Not you. Like
what happened? Yeah, what happened over the weekend?
The fall is gone.
Our
clothes.
Clocks back an hour. We got a gained a whole hour.
Wait, we now your eyelash. Wasn't your face?
Yeah.
You be so beautiful. Tuesday, third.
This year.
We'll fall. Oh,
come on,
Mr. Daddy! It's a new month song! Woo! Yeah. Here comes November! October ended.
I love Thanksgiving Day.
Mmm.
Okay. When we look at November, we've got three special days. Hannah, what three special days do we have in November?
I will come here on Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving, yeah. And then we have
no Veterans Day.
And then Election Day, right? We have how many days off? We have the red X's show our days off. How many days off do we have in November?
4.
We have 4. Yeah. We have 4 no school days. Well, 5 because we have Thanksgiving off too. What days do we have off in November? What number?
November 26th is Thanksgiving. I don't have school.
That's right. The 26th is one day we don't have school. What other numbers do we not have school on?
Okay.
Oh,
like 11.
I don't come
30.
On
Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
25.
27.
Yeah. That's good. Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Alejandro, what days do we not have school?
You mean that we don't have school?
Right.
Yes, it's still Thanksgiving
it's
on school.
Wednesday, 11th and 25, and Fridays, 13 and 27.
Right.
You forgot the holiday, 26.
Right. Because I didn't put an X on that one. You're
because
right.
On holidays, we have no school.
That's right. You're right. Thank you. Yeah. That's right.
What?
Mm-hmm. We have.
Cool.
Yeah. Let's take a look at this video.
Welcome to Kids Academy. Hi, boys and girls. Do you know what it means to vote? When people vote, they make an important choice. What if your family couldn't decide what to make for
dinner tomorrow?
What do you do?
It's raining.
Vote to choose a dish. What if your basketball team needs a new captain? Take a vote.
What?
As a citizen, voting is very important.
Grown-ups
who are 18 and older vote when it is time to choose new leaders for a community. This could be the mayor of a city or the governor of a state. Citizens even vote for the president of the United States. Let's see what happens when people vote.
Good. Okay, we're slow.
On election day, citizens go to a special place, like a library or a school gym.
I'm school.
In their community.
Inside, there are many voting booths.
Select your choices on a ballot and put it in the ballot box.
Voting booth.
Not voting booth. In a special computer place set of ballot boxes. After all the votes have been counted, a new leader is chosen.
I'm gone.
When people vote, they make important choices. Citizens vote for leaders such as mayors, governors, and presidents. Election Day is a special day for voting. Voters select their choices on a ballot and place it in a ballot box. Votes are counted, and a new leader is chosen. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.
Subscribe to our channel to stay updated on.
Okay, so in Oregon, we don't actually go to a place to vote. We have mail-in ballots. So they send us our ballots in the mail and we fill them out. And then we we mail them back. Okay, we know the month, the weather. Okay. I don't think we have time for the weather song. Why not? Because we got to get to the other stuff. It's fun. Okay, look out your window. What's the weather today? Eden, what's the weather today?
It's sunny.
It is sunny. Hannah, what's the weather out your window?
Cloudy.
Cloudy. Emily, what's the weather out your window?
Sunny.
Sunny. Okay, good. Alejandro, what's the weather out your window?
It's sunny outside.
It's sunny. Okay. Genesis, what's the weather out your window? Oh, bummer. Genesis is not with us. I'm sad. All right, sunny. Okay, so in October, we had sunny days, cloudy and foggy days, and rainy days. Which had the most? Which had the most?
Sunny is most.
Sunny is most? Yeah, I would agree. Which had the least? Emily, which one had the least?
Emily, pumpkin.
Oh, Hannah, we're talking about the weather right now.
Not pumpkins.
Emily, which one had the least?
Cloudy.
Cloudy? Or yeah. Rainy?
Rainy.
Rainy. Rainy had the least. That's right. Rainy had the least. Did we have any that had a tie? Did any have the same?
Emily, blonde.
Oh, Hannah, what are we talking about right now?
Weather.
The weather. Did any of the weather ones have the same? Aiden, were any of the weather ones the same? Yes or no?
No. Yes.
Yes, which ones were the same? Rainy and rainy, windy, or stormy and snowy. They both had zero. They both had zero. You're right, Aiden. There were some that were the same. Nice job. I see that our friends are back. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi.
How did circle go?
It went, oh, well.
Good. Good. Okay. We're just.
Our kiddos came back, but.
Okay, let's take
Calvin, I think, is still there.
Probably.
Okay.
Nolan disappeared on us.
And Brendan did too. I don't know where he is.
Brendan's back.
Emily Blunt.
All right. Here we go. Here's our friend.
Okay.
So we have some new vocabulary. Hannah, read this one.
Candidate.
Yeah. Read this bottom part, please, Hannah.
A person who wants to be a government leader.
A person that wants to be a government leader. That's right. Alejandro, read this one.
Election day.
Yeah.
The day voters vote for new leaders and laws.
Right, good. Emily, can you read this one?
No voter.
Voter. Mm-hmm. Can you read the blue part down here, please?
To start something.
A person who votes. Good job. All right. Aiden, read this one over here.
Okay.
Thanks.
It's choose.
Look at the word.
What does S-E-L-E-C-T spell?
Select.
Select. I don't know what this word is.
Look at the word. Something. Thank you. All right, those are our new words. Candidate, election day, voter, and choose. Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Okay, we watched this one already. Let's see. We are talking about this today, guys, because we have election day tomorrow and it is a presidential election. It's a big deal. That's a very big deal. Very big deal. We're going to talk about it quite a bit today and tomorrow.
You better take a stand, man. You can make a game plan. The future is in your hands. Back in the day, we had kings and queens. We had to beg them if we wanted anything. A dictator doesn't get elected, that's what talks. The people are in charge, yeah, let's hear it for democracy. Your beliefs really matter, it's important to express them. Voting is the best way to profess them. If nobody votes, then the few will decide. Speak your mind with your vote, you will do it nationwide. Raise up your hands. for the government when you turn 18, but before that, you can still vote for other things. Class president or your favorite TV show. What's eat for lunch on the greatest sports row? Your voice can be heard. All you gotta do is use it. Tell a politician what you think. I'm about to listen to it. Kids these days have a lot to say, and the world of tomorrow is created today. You have a point of view, yo. Who's reppin' it? Do you see my vote pins? Yeah, I'm high stepping it. Wanna be the one who didn't speak up? What new ideas will you dream up? Look, I would think, hey, who made that rule? Voting is democracy's most powerful tool. Yeah, read about the issues and choose a favorite candidate. You may be a kid, but I know that you can hear me. Raise up your hand, kid. You better take a stand in. You can make the game clear. You can get the door in. Who's gonna vote me? That's who. What are we gonna vote? It's the right thing to do. What are we gonna vote? Every time we get a chance. After you vote. Do the democracy dance. Who's gonna vote me? That's who. What are we gonna vote? It's the right thing to do. What are we gonna vote? Every time we get a chance. Do the democracy dance. Raise up your hand, kid. You better take a stand. You can make the game clear. If you just adore a vote, who's gonna vote?
Vote. It is your civic responsibility to vote. How old do you have to be to vote? They said it in the song. Who heard it? Alejandro, did you hear it?
Yes.
How old do you have to be to vote?
I don't know.
18. You have to be 18. Are you 18? 18? Yeah. Are you 18?
Oh, yes.
Are you 18, Alejandro?
No, I'm still 9.
Oh, darn it. Mom's 18?
What?
Is mom 18? Can she vote?
No.
No? How old is mom?
I don't know.
Oh, shoot. How about dad?
My dad is 37 years old.
Oh, is he old enough to vote?
No, enough to vote.
He's old enough to vote? Phew, that's good. I bet your mom can vote too. Yeah. I bet she's old enough. She might be like 19.
Okay. Oh, Alejandro, yeah. Miss Rossetti's teasing you.
Wait, you could go ask.
I don't want to talk about it in the house. Miss Rossetti.
What?
You're teasing me.
Yeah, I'm teasing you a little bit, but I'm trying to see if you understand I'm trying to see if you understand that both mom and dad are old enough that they can go vote. That's what I'm trying to get at. Yeah, they are. Yeah. You can ask mom. Mom, did you vote? Yeah. Hannah, how old do you have to be to vote?
18.
18. Are you 18?
No.
No? Oh, shoot. Can you vote? No, not yet. Not yet. Can mom vote?
Yes.
Anna, can mom vote?
No.
No? How come? No. Is mom not 18?
No.
Shoot. We're in big trouble here, folks. Emily. Are you 18?
No.
No, shoot. Can you vote?
No.
No. How about mom? Is mom 18?
No.
No, is she older than 18? Can she vote?
Yeah.
Yeah, she can. Good job, Emily. Good job. All right. Let's see. We're going to come back to this in just a second. We're going to go to our next slide. Okay. Because this is a presidential election, it's a very important one. November 3rd is our election day. It's a presidential election. We're voting for the next president. And every 4 years in America, we vote for a new president. Every 4 years. And there are three different political parties in America. There's the Republican Party, the Democratic Party, and the Libertarian Party. What shape is the Republican Party? What shape is that? What shape? What shape does that look like?
It looks like an animal to me, Miss Betty.
It does look like an animal, Miss Beth. I wonder what animal it is. What animal might that be? Brendan, what animal is this?
Elephant.
Elephant. Good job. Good job. Okay, the Democratic Party is what shape? Shape. What shape? What shape? Genesis, do you know?
Genesis, you're muted. There you go.
What shape is that?
It's an elephant.
This one is an elephant, yes. What about the Democratic Party? What shape is their animal?
A horse?
Dog. Donkey.
Donkey.
Yeah. Donkey. Right. And the Libertarian Party. Could be a hedgehog. I thought it was
a hedgehog.
I thought it was a porcupine. I never knew. We don't really hear too much about this one. We mostly hear about the Republican Party and the Democratic Party. We don't hear too much about this one. Okay, we have, these are our, what's this word again? These are our presidential candidates. Thank you, Alejandro. Our candidates. That's right. The Republican Party candidate is Donald Trump. He is our president now.
Okay.
The Democratic Party, the candidate is Joe Biden. He used to be the vice president from 2009 to 2017, I believe. And for the Libertarian Party, the candidate is Joe Jorgensen. And she's never been in office before. Again, we don't hear too much about the Democratic Party and the Republican Party. Yeah.
Miss Rossetti, I looked up the Libertarian Party symbol. It's a porcupine.
Porcupine, that's what I thought. Yeah. I thought that was a porcupine, although a hedgehog was a very good guess.
I think so.
Yeah, but it is a porcupine. Thank you, Miss Beth. All right, so we have three candidates. Okay, we have the Republican Party candidate, Donald Trump, who is our president now. Our Democratic Party candidate, Joe Biden, who used to be the vice president. And the Libertarian Party candidate, Joe Jorgensen. Okay. All right. Who knows what the president does? What is the president's job? What do they do? That's a tough question. I don't know if I put that video in here. I don't think I did. I don't think I did.
Mom, I've been working on the costume.
I don't think I did. Because we... Let's see. Aiden, do you know what the president does? Maybe not. We got a lot of freezing. I might be the one that's freezing. Let's see here. We are going to go to and find out what the president's job is. All right, whoops. Let's see what the president does. That's kind of a job, that president.
Hello, boys and girls. Today, we're going to talk about the president's job. In the United States, the president is the leader of the executive branch. Do you know what the president does? Let's find out. U.S. citizens vote for a new president every 4 years. They choose from a group of people called candidates. These candidates want to become the next president of the United States of America. But not everyone can be a president. There are a few special rules. The president of the United States must be a U.S. citizen born in America, at least 35 years old, a U.S. resident, or someone who lives in America for at least 14 years. Is elected, they become the leader of the executive branch. The president is also known as the commander-in-chief of the United States Armed Forces. The ceremony marking the beginning of a new president's duties takes place in front of the Capitol building in Washington, D.C. At the ceremony, the new leader of the country promises to preserve and protect the Constitution of the United States. Then the new president moves to the White House to live and work. The White House is located in Washington, D.C., which is the capital of the United States. Each morning, the president goes to the Oval Office of the White House to work. One of the president's duties is to sign important papers. These can include bills passed by Congress. The U.S. president nominates a group of people who will advise and assist him in his duties. Together, these people form the cabinet of the United States. Ambassadors, Supreme Court judges, and other senior officials are also nominated by the president. The president of the United States travels all over the world to talk to other leaders.
Men.
For watching. Goodbye.
Subscribe to our channel to stay updated on new videos. Find links to our apps in the comments below.
Okay. Do you think the president's job is important? Yeah. Yes or no? Yes, the president's job is important. You should see a thumbs up. Thank you, Aiden. Thank you. Alejandro, thank you. Genesis, thank you. Matt Moen, thank you. That was a great thumbs up. Thank you, Emily. Yeah, the president's job is very, very important. He governs the whole country. Make sure that we are safe and that we have safe, that we have good rules and laws in place, yeah? Okay, let's see. We have time for one story. One story.
I don't think so. I don't think so. It's not working. Yes, it does.
Welcome to Storyline Online, brought to you by the SAG-AFTRA Foundation. I'm Lonnie Chavis.
I'm Mackenzie Hansack.
And I'm Parker Bates. And today, we're going to read
If I Ran for President,
written by Katherine Steyer and illustrated by Lynn Applecraft.
If I Ran for President.
It will be great to run for President of the United States. If I ran for President, I'd hope the people of the United States would choose me for a very important job. The job?
Yes, it does.
And I'd hope to follow in the footsteps of past presidents, such as George Washington, first president, Thomas Jefferson, Theodore Roosevelt, and Abraham Lincoln. I'd have to think carefully about my decision to run for president. I want to know how my family felt about it, too. Then I'd ask myself, am I the best person for the job? Am I ready to work very, very, very hard for my country? Do lots of people believe in me? And will they help me run for office? If I can answer yes to all those questions, then I declare my candidacy. That means I'd announce I was interested in the job of President of the United States. If I ran for president, I'd run a campaign to let voters learn all about me. People who thought I would be a good president would donate money or time to help. I'd hire people to work on my campaign, too. Campaigns can make a candidate famous. Soon my name or face would appear on signs, buttons, bumper stickers, and t-shirts. I'd even star in television commercials.
And if I ran for president, I'd work with my political party. That's a group of people who share the same beliefs about how the country should be governed. They support candidates who uphold these ideas. The two major parties...
You can go to Canvas and Trees.
And the Republican
Trees?
Party. There are other parties too, but people besides me would want to
go to the guy.
Republican and Democratic parties must
really, really fast you can.
Some states like Iowa,
that
sometimes sounds like caucus, where members pick their favorite kid. In most states, party members hold an election called a primary. Caucuses and primaries show which candidates are popular with voters and who might have the best chance of being elected president. The first primary is held in New Hampshire in the winter before the presidential election. I'd be sure to visit there, but I'd have to bundle up. In the summer before the election, the political parties announce their candidate for president. The major parties make this announcement at meetings called conventions. Each state sends delegates to the convention. Delegates vote for the candidate who was most popular in their state. A convention looks like a big celebration full of cheering and chanting, balloons and confetti. Millions of Americans watch the excitement on TV. By the time of the convention, everyone usually knows which candidate will be chosen, but the delegates still hold a vote. If my party chose me to run for president, I'd make a speech to get everyone excited about helping me win. I tell the American people about my platform, my plans, and ideas for our country. My running mate would make a speech too. That's the person who would be my vice president if I became president. If I ran for president, I'd be invited to debate with other presidential candidates. A person called a moderator would ask us questions. People across the country would listen carefully to our answers. Reporters would ask me questions too, about my life, my family, even my kid and Sassy. They'd print old photographs of me in newspapers and magazines, like the snapshot of me in my superhero costume, or my baby picture when I still wore diapers. If I ran for president, I would travel the country to meet lots of people. I'd have my own campaign bus or airplane to take me from place to place. Inside, there'd be comfy seats, perfect for checking out the news, writing speeches, and thinking about how to solve the nation's problems. I take naps too. I need the extra rest. I'd work hard and be very busy. All in 1 week, I might share cereal with kindergartners in California, crunch corn with farmers in Kansas, and have dinner in Delaware, where I'd order the blue plate special with an apple pie and a large strawberry milkshake. After all that food, I might not feel too well. Still, I'd have to smile and talk with the people I met. Presidential candidates make lots of speeches, shake hands, and cuddle babies.
Finally, in November, election day would arrive. If I ran for president, I'd be nervous and excited. On election day, millions of voters from across the country go to their polling places to cast their ballots. That's another way to say that they vote. In our country, people vote in private. No one but you knows how you voted. But I'd know I choose my favorite candidate, me. Once the voting is finished, officials count up the ballots. Then comes the announcement on television, radio, in the newspapers, and on the internet. People everywhere find out who will be the next president of the United States. I'd stay up late and keep my fingers crossed.
If I ran for president and lost, the people who worked so hard on my campaign would be disappointed. I'd be disappointed too. Still, I would be proud that I have taken part in a free and fair election. I'd make a telephone call to offer my best wishes and my support to the winner, our next president. But if I won, wow! On January 20th, I say the words of the oath of office and be sworn in as president. On that day, my inauguration day, there'd be a parade and a fancy ball. Then I'd move into the White House in Washington, D.C. to begin my 4-year term as president of the United States of America. And what would I do when I became president? Well, that's another story. The end! I learned a lot from this book. It's not just about running for president. It's also about being a good citizen and voting.
Yeah, I can't wait to turn 18 when I get to vote. I'm going to register to vote when I'm 17, so I'm ready to go. It's up to us to elect people who represent us the best.
Yeah, voting is super important. I go with my mom to the polls when she votes. It's a lot of fun, too. And as kids, we have to remember, we have a voice, too. Even though we can't vote yet, we can still use our voice to make change.
That's true. Hey, thank you for watching Storyline Online.
Make sure you check out all of our stories.
Keep watching and keep reading.
All right, that was a great story. What if you ran for president? What if you became president? What would you do? Oh my goodness.
I'll vote when I was 18 years old.
Yeah, that's a great idea. What would you do if you became president, Alejandro? If you ran for president and became president, what would you do? That's a big thing. If I became president, I would say naps every day for everybody. That's the law. What would you do?
If I ran for president, I would say everyone will merge mess if they go to stop. Do you be safe? And I will, then you will be president tomorrow.
That's a good idea. Emily, do you think you'd want to be president?
No.
I don't blame you.
You could make lots of good changes. Dance party every day. Yeah. Might be fun. Only nice words. Nobody can use bad words. Only nice words and kind words. Lots of things we could do if we were president. Yeah, but it's important. That we take responsibility and we vote. It's our job. Okay, my friends, we went over a little bit. It is time for our break. And we will have PE with Mr. Miller. You will need a stuffy today and a target. Okay, a stuffy and a target. And we have only about 11 minutes until PE. Only about 11 minutes until PE.
Okay, 11 minutes.
Yeah, a stuffy and a target, like a basket or a pillow or something like that. Okay. I will set the timer.